The wolf shall also dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. That's from the Bible, Isaiah 11:6 to be exact. And it's where we get the title of this Star Trek story, And the Children Shall Lead. It is, as we'll discover, a sarcastic title, because the children we're about to meet have lost touch with their own horrifying reality. The only direction in which these children could lead would have tragic consequences for those who might follow. For the children and for the audience as well, things are not what they appear to be. And the Children Shall Lead stars the famous lawyer Melvin Belli, complete with an incredible makeup job. It's a good thing he didn't quit his day job, because I think we'd all agree he was a better lawyer than an actor. Basically, he was cast in a desperate attempt to get a ratings boost. Plus, he was a personal friend of the producer. That's Hollywood. Once again, an evil entity has been vanquished. The Gorgon follows a long list of evil entities who've met their collective fates at the hands of the Enterprise crew. Consider some of Star Trek's more intriguing villains. The Probe, Nomad in The Changeling, an ancient evil force named Redjack that was once called Jack the Ripper in Wolf in the Fold, and an all-powerful being with a sense of humor known as Trelane in The Squire of Gothos. If, as someone once said, the measure of a man may be taken by the stature of his enemies, then surely Kirk and company are most formidable.